Chris is on the line in Ohio to start off this hour. Hey, Chris, how are you?
I'm doing great, Dave. God bless you. I love what you do. I've got a question. I know it's bold because I want to see if I'm an exception to the rule.
Okay.
I'm on baby step two. I've got a household income of $200,000. Debt is $30,000 student loan. That's all I've got. Mm-hmm. I've got $15,000 in cash. And here's the rub. I want to see if it makes more sense for me to use that cash for closing costs on a refi, because I'm in real high property taxes, so I think I'm going to need some cash to refi. But I know I can go from a 30 to a 15 and either maintain or reduce my expenses, but I don't know if that's an exception to the rule or how I should be thinking about this.
Okay, the property taxes being high would not affect your need for cash except for prepaids, and all of that can be rolled into the refi if you've got equity or you don't have any equity.
I don't have much. My house is was a $335,000 mortgage. I'm down to $310,000.
Okay. What I would do is discuss it with the mortgage company. If you can roll the closing costs and the prepaids into the closing, I would do that. I would not come out of pocket for cash. What's your current interest rate?
4.5%.
Okay. Yeah, you can probably get a 3 on a 15-year roughly. Right now, and so I'd save a point and a half, which is going to be like $4,500 a year in savings on the interest. To move from a 30 to a 15, I wouldn't refinance, but to move from a 4.5 to a 3, I surely would. Especially if you're going to stay in the house. You know you're going to stay in the house, right?
It's my dream house.
Okay. All right, cool. So what I would do is roll your closing costs in, and then that doesn't change your cash position at all. All it does is change the structure and get you a lower interest rate, and then you take that cash and use it to get the half of your student loans gone and use your fabulous income to knock them off. So otherwise, if you can't roll it in, here's what I would do. I would not do the refinance right now. I would first get rid of the student loans. I know that that's going to be fairly easy because you have $15,000 in the bank towards your 30 and you make $200,000. So you should be debt-free by September. And then refinance. You're not going to, rates may tick up a little by September, but they're not going to be substantially different. It probably still going to make sense to refinance in September, probably similar numbers. I don't know how long these rates are going to stay. They're artificially low right now, probably. That's my thought anyway. So, I think the economic environment we're in has driven the rates down with the Fed dropping rates and so forth as well. So, anyway, all that to say, I think you're pretty safe. You might get a 3.25% in September or something like that, or even a 3.5%, but it'll still make sense to refinance. And I would wait if you have to come out of pocket with cash until you clear the student loan. So overall, the answer is you're not the exception. Good try, though.